G said the team that played the longest, the strongest win. So we just we was playing real strong at the end of the game. That's just us. We like it when it's hard. So like Coach Herm said, so that's just us, honestly.
Jaden, can you just kind of take us through that 15 play drive, 75 yards? You guys took 6 minutes on the clock. What was working on that drive?
I give all props to the offensive line. They got the run game going today. I mean, Eno did a phenomenal job. Offensive line did a phenomenal job with the run game. So, I mean, that's really the bread and butter, just getting the run game going, getting everybody in the rhythm, getting Eno going. You can, and it showed on that drive, you know, picking up first downs or critical third downs. It's moving the chains and eating up the clock because we knew that this was the drive to go down and score. We did it, and then we get and defense came out and got us the ball back. You know, just phenomenal job in all phases.
Jim, can you tell us about the scrambling? Especially, so one of the first plays of the game, it looked like you rolled one direction and went all the way back the other way. I wonder, was that design, were the scrambles designed this week, or was that something that you were improvising on the spot?
It was improvising. Really just going out there, just taking what the defense gives you, going out there, just making a play, but not trying to do too much to cost the game or anything else, get myself hurt. So really just going out there. The Cal did a great job. They overflowed to everything. So, I mean, there's a couple cutback lanes for me on rollout plays and design plays. But really just looking at some of the scrambles, just third down the distance. They got high speed rushes. So I just stepped in the pocket. If nothing was there, just take off and just get what you could get. Get a first down, just move the chains.
Shari, this was a very physical football game. And Danny Gonzalez called you guys a little bit soft after the last game. Do you guys take that to heart, or have you felt that you responded from after that last one?
We all took that to heart because I felt like we was playing a lot. Like we wasn't us. Colorado game, we was playing a little bit soft, and I agree with them. So we had to honestly we just had to do us, and I felt like that's what we did this game. Once we get started, I feel like we untouchable. Nobody can stop us on the defensive side. No cap.
So you know, this game would kind of maybe reminded a lot of Michigan State in some ways. It was really, really hard to run on them, but actually found more success today than we did 2 weeks ago. What do you think the keys were?
I think we're growing as a unit, both offensively and defensively. We're just learning how to play with each other, and I think we did a good job of doing that tonight.
You think having a same offensive line now for 3 games in a row, is that part of the growth on offense?
Oh, yeah. Yes, sir. It's definitely helping. Continuity, that goes a long way. And so we had some new paces. We were working them in, and I think we're starting to get comfortable with where we're at.
Darren, can you just talk about the first drive of in the second half where they ran it just 12 times and scored, and then how you guys responded subsequently in the half?
First drive, you could tell they just wanted to get the athletes the ball. They wanted to get us tired, trying to run sideline to sideline, get us running. But I feel like they balanced it out good with running the ball and passing the ball. But I feel we had an advantage with the quarterbacks coming out.
Did you guys change anything in the second half after the first quarter?
Yeah, the way we played, just play harder. More sound. I feel like when we all on the same page, it's hard to stop us. It's hard to get anywhere by us.
What about the pass rush? I mean, obviously a huge issue last week. Tonight wasn't an issue at all.
That's something we worked in practice. We stressed a lot. Coaches were on us a lot about it. You could just see out there tonight, guys are getting tired of hearing it. So did something about it.
Did you guys feel like you were challenged by Danny Gonzalez after that last game just to kind of man up a little bit more?
Oh, definitely. I mean, coaches make mistakes too, but being a player, you know, he's not out there playing us, so we got to overcome him. So.
You know, did you come out with the team at halftime to warm up, or were you still in the locker room?
I was still in the locker room. I think I was using the restroom at that time.
Yeah.
The two touchdown runs, the first two, you just seemed like you wouldn't be denied. Can you just kind of tell us about your mindset on those plays, especially the first one where you ran 13?
I think last week we attempted too many field goals, and I think it was a big issue. We knew it was an issue that we need to go score points, and so I knew that it could either be whatever down it was either the next down or touchdown. And so in my head, I was just thinking touchdown, touchdown. Offensive line did a really good job of blocking that front. I'm thinking of one touchdown, I think it was the first one. They did a really good job, I saw it from the go. I told Jaden, this is the one, I want the ball. And so offensive line did their job and we ended up in the end zone.
Jaden, when you compare what you saw on film from Cal all week long and what you saw tonight, was it really much different with the running on defense?
Not really. They're really they have a lot of great effort, so they're hustling to the ball. A very disciplined team. So, I mean, they were trying to limit us from the big plays, which they did that most of the game. But, I mean, we capitalized on the opportunities that we had. We just converted and just kept moving the chains and started drives as an offense instead of, like, in the past, just big plays. We sustained drives, so that was a big deal for us.
Beating two ranked teams on the road so far, especially for kind of a young team, what do you guys make of that? Like what does it say about you guys?
We're just growing. Really just a continuity. We like playing on the road. We just like playing the tough teams. We like being the underdogs team. People down us. So, I mean, we just like playing on the road. We just like playing tough teams. And if you don't believe in us, we believe in ourselves.
Time for three more.
You know, when that last drive started, just what was the mentality you had as far as, like, we've got to go 75 some yards to take a lead in this game?
I think I was sitting on the sideline next to, I think it was Jerry Neely. And I think this is when we just turned over the ball. And I was like, there's no way we're going to allow this to happen. They don't have their starting QB. We've got to take advantage of it. And so we got back on the field. I told Jaden, I told BA, I told Cal Williams, and I told Frank Darby, let's go win this game. And big plays were made when we needed it. He used his legs to go get us a first down at one point, and that's what it's going to take. Big players making big time plays in the time that it's needed.
What's the difference in the mindset getting a win before the bye week and if you guys were to lose this game and go in at 3-2, the difference there?
I don't think there'd be much of a difference. We're always going to move forward. We're always going to work hard to win the next game. And so at the end of the day, we're just glad we're on the winning side, and so we don't have to think about that.
For the defensive guys, you held them to a field goal after the turnover. What was your mindset at that time when you went out on the field?
Just when the offense is in the red zone, it doesn't mean they necessarily have to score. So that's something we stress a lot on the defensive side. Our defense coordinator likes to get a lot of pressure, so our DBs understand that they got to cover. So I think they did a pretty good job today with that.
Thank you.